Good evening and welcome to Connecting Point. I'm Jim Madigan. Tonight, Connecting Point contributor Carolee McGrath profiles the Franklin County Technical School that's helping students find what they're passionate about and turning that passion into a career.
This program is part of American Graduate. Let's make it happen. A public media initiative made possible by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting.
Seventeen-year-old Brandon Tarbox has it all figured out. And that's not an exaggeration.
Ultimately, I have desires of operating my own machine tool business, primarily doing gunsmithing and contract EDM work, which is electronic discharge machining. And I'm not sure exactly how I'm going to go about getting there yet.
But Brandon says he'll find a way. The senior at Franklin County Technical High School is already working as a CNC machinist and programmer at the Dumont Company in Greenfield. The company manufactures precision broaching tools for machine companies. He's enrolled in Franklin County Tech's machine technology program. He's taking honors courses and taking full advantage of every opportunity that comes his way.
I was working full-time over the summer, so I've been exposed to that. I can handle it. I think it's a good experience. And my plan for the end of school is to begin working there full-time.
Brandon and others in the machine technology department have their sights set on graduating and making good money with a high school degree.
And this school is making even more efforts to try to bring the shops to a point where they're operating almost like a company on a little bit more of stringent deadlines. That sort of environment trains you better so that when it's critical that you meet those deadlines, it's critical that you're performing at your best, you're used to doing so.
So, what did you set last?
There's a lot of industry around here that is starving for skilled help. We have a work co-op program where in their senior year they get to go out and work in industry. Starting pay would be $12 an hour, and they have the potential to be making within a year upwards of $20 an hour.
That's about $41,000 a year for a 19 or 20-year-old without a college degree and no student loans. It sounds like a good deal to junior Brandon Buda. He admits school wasn't always his thing.
When you were in eighth grade, did you want to get up every morning and go to school?
No, I didn't really like school at all. It was just kind of a chore.
But now Brandon is hoping to graduate from machine technology, get a job, and continue on to college, just like his brother, who also graduated from the school.
He's an app developer, and his company is Temple Studios.
And how old is he?
He's 19 years old.
And he's going to college?
Yep.
So he's doing okay?
He's doing very well for his age.
Richard Martin is the principal and assistant superintendent for the high school, which covers 19 rural towns. He says the technical school route for some students is the pathway to success.
The students begin to realize through the shop experience that a certain amount of math would be required in order for them to access the next level of machining. So a lot of the kids will then begin to relook at their passion for math and dive into a new level of that. So now they're able to connect the vocational with the academics and see that that's a clear pathway for a career.
Last year, this shop was retooled with all new equipment. It's all state-of-the-art technology. And several local businesses came together to kick in more than $200,000 to make this happen. Steve Capshaw, who owns Valley Steel Stamp, led that campaign because of the need for highly skilled workers in the area. In addition to the funding from local companies, the state put $250,000 toward the machine technology department. Another $400,000 came from grants and the Regional Employment Board.
We got rid of many old machines that dated back to the 1950s, and in came approximately 13 brand new CNC state-of-the-art machines.
Martin says the dropout rate at Franklin County Tech, which has 538 students, is less than 1%, and the graduation rate is in the high 90s. In addition to machine technology, the school offers several programs, including business and health technology, automotive, and landscaping. Haley Lowell hopes to not only get a job, but to do dual enrollment her senior year at a community college.
What would your advice be to kids in a different school who think that they just want to quit?
Don't quit. Don't give up on your dreams, because if you do, you're not going to get anywhere.
For Haley and others, quitting is not even in their vocabulary. They're looking forward to the future and all of the promise it holds.
If you have the motivation to learn and you make good use of the time you have, you can learn just as much, I think, in the same amount of time. And you're able to learn more because of the trade area. If you don't want to go on to college, so be it. You go to a technical school like this, you do a program like this, and by the time you're finished, you have a good chance of making a decent wage.
Reporting for Connecting Point, I'm Carolee McGrath.